Virgo. All that I need to know about your person moving forward. So let's start. First three cards for you, and then we move to your person for Sun, Moon, Rising. Virgo for the month of June. Let's take next 2 or 3 weeks. Okay, so many of you guys are holding back right now, not really doing anything about your connection or your person. I see you just relaxing, just trying to heal yourself, just trying to fix yourself, just trying to get a hold as to what is happening in your life. You know, trying to get a, you know, like a whole new view as to what this person is about. Cups, I see a lot of confusion going in your life. With Queen of Pentacles, it's like you're also focused on your financial life or your family life. But when it comes to your person, there is no clarity. Okay, I see you holding back as well. I do not see you eagerly putting in that effort or making the first move. You're waiting on this person to see what this person is doing or what they're about. Okay, one more card as to what's happening with Virgo, please. With Ace of Pentacles in the reverse, finances could be a bit difficult this month, okay? You do not feel financially stable this month. Like, things are not going your way when it comes to your financial life. It's not like you do not make enough. It's just that you don't feel stable enough. If it's about promotion or if it's about a new job, there could be a certain amount of delay, okay? It's not like it won't happen. It just won't happen this couple of, weeks, okay? One more card as to what else is coming for Virgo. It's like some stagnancy going on in your financial life, okay? So with King of Swords, I see you being very practical this whole month ahead, okay? I see you trying to make practical decisions, trying to have a very clear mindset, not letting your emotions get the better of you, okay? In terms of your connection, what's to come? One card for the connection, please. Overall energy, please. So in terms of your connection, I see King of Cups in the reverse. That means that you or your person are not clearly opening up, okay? I definitely feel that someone is sabotaging their feelings. Someone is kind of, numb towards this connection, not wanting to speak about their feelings, not wanting to be emotionally available. So I also see a bit of, like your person is kind of manipulating you emotionally in the past, or they have been. I see this person not being honest with you with King of Cups. It's like sometimes whenever you try to open up, you always felt like, you know, this person was kind of using you or just wanting to get like whatever they can get from you, and you did not like that energy. Some of you were even drained being a part of this connection. One more card in terms of your person. Let's take one card for what are they up to. In terms of your person, I see your person being silent. I do not know if you guys are dealing with a Pisces or a Cancer, okay? But I do feel your person is a bit silent right now. It's like they are not wanting to completely stay open to this connection or be vocal about their feelings, okay? I do not see that. One more card. In terms of how do they think about you now? How does this Virgo soulmate think about Virgo now? If they are in communication terms, I see them not wanting to open up about their emotion or keeping secrets. In terms of their energy, I still see them sexually being around, sexually still flirting with you or still kind of trying to, be all playful about this connection, not trying to take things seriously. A Knight of Wands is not a serious card. It's like they still want to have fun, okay? One card for their energy towards you. What's Virgo soulmate's energy like towards Virgo for the next couple of weeks, please? In terms of energy with Six of Cups, they definitely want to be around you, okay? Even if they have been silent, I still see them not wanting to stay or walk away. They might be not wanting to open up their emotions, but that doesn't mean they won't completely, be around you, okay? It's like this person wants to have a playful connection with you, not want to get very serious. Some of you, this person is a very close friend for whom you have feelings for, okay? But in terms of their intentions towards Virgo, please, one card for their intentions towards Virgo. In terms of their intentions towards Virgo, I see them holding their emotions back, okay? I also see resistance when it comes to communication. They have been resisting from clearly being available to you. I'm not saying that they won't communicate. It's just that they are holding back that regular communication, or that, you know, like whenever you message them, they might take some time to reply. Okay, they might not show you that they're clearly, you know, like interested. One card for what action do they want to take towards you now? What action does this person want to take towards the work group, please? In terms of action with Temperance card, they definitely want to be on the same page as you. It's not like they want to quit on you or they want to stay away from you. It's just that they want to not show you that they are clearly interested. They might take their sweet time to reply or sweet time to come forward, okay? But what's this person up to, Spirit? What's this person clearly up to when it comes to this connection? With a five of pentacles, it's like they do not want to give you much. It's like they want to keep you at a very minimal, you know, like how do I put it, like they want to breadcrumb you. Okay, how do they view Virgo now? How do they clearly view Virgo? I don't see them like giving you much. Okay, with nine of cups, they want you to be around them, they want you to still give them attention, but when it comes to them, they do not want to give that same amount of love, affection and attention to you. Okay, why are they doing this? What's the major blockage, Spirit? This person clearly thinks like they are above you. Okay, with two of wands, I see them being at crossroads. They are not 100% serious about you or 100% focused on you. I do see them having other options. Okay, one card for their current feelings towards you. How do they feel for Virgo now? How does this person feel for Virgo, please? Okay, with Queen of Cups, this person is clearly sabotaging their feelings. Even after having feelings for you, they are not ready to express it. It's like they are blocking their own heart and they want to be super practical about it. One more card. What do they have in their heart space for Virgo? It's like this person does not want to get like married to you. They are clearly not, you know, like putting in that serious effort. They are just wanting to be around, and that's their energy. With Three of Pentacles, they are completely resisting from building this connection with you or putting in that like necessary effort that's going to get you to to the next stage. Okay, let's bring you one more card as to what's really happening in this connection, what's really getting in the way, or what's the major shift that is going on. The major shift is this person is not wanting to hold on to you for long. I'm sorry it came off this way, but I'm trying to be honest with you, and you guys being practical can understand this reading better. With Nine of Swords, this person is clearly not interested for the long term part of it. Like, you know, they want to be around till the time they can. Okay, but if they find something other that is way more interesting, they might go towards that as well. Okay, like one more card as to how do they view this connection. How does this person clearly view this connection? A big narcissist, okay, a big devil that you're dealing with. With Four of Pentacles, they are just holding on to it, you know, till the time they can find something better. So not a good person. With the Death card, this person is not willing to change, and that's been the major blockage. So for now, where do we see this going? For now, where do we see this going for Virgo and their soulmate? I mean, with Seven of Pentacles, you cannot expect much. Okay, there is going to be some communication, but not much. But clearly, this person is keeping things stagnant on purpose. Okay, they do not want things to move forward. Okay, like one card for where things would go by end of this month. Where do you see the things going by end of this month? For many of you, this person is just a lesson, okay? And many of you guys might just drop them eventually. But for now, I believe this person only came to your life to teach you lessons, to teach you to set boundaries, to teach you your self-worth, okay? With Hierophant card is not always about commitment. It's also about lessons. It's about learning something through the process, okay? So what else does Virgo need to know about? They do have feelings, but, you know, this person is kind of focused on not wanting to move things forward with you for some reason. Okay, I can't have you, but I can't give up as well. This person might be bound elsewhere. Okay, I can't have you is one message. So for some of you, your person might be already in another committed relationship. Not for all, like for 20% of you. The remaining 80%, I believe your person is looking up for better options. One more card for Virgo and your soulmate. So for some of it, I mean, this could have been a friendship that kind of got, you know, to this point. Okay, a vacant love, I see you now. So in the past, I believe they did open up to you in some which way or form, but then they got closed off again. Lies, betrayal, and sweet words. This person is all about sweet words, and when it comes to taking action, they do not do that. Okay, or they do not put that serious effort, and it always remains this way. And you guys are going through a cycle month after month, and this has been repeating. And if it's a cycle, if it's a pattern where this person keeps putting you through shit time and time again, it's time to give up, darling. It's time to see your worth. No one deserves this bullshit. When you're clearly giving someone honest love, honest attention, when you're being loyal, you do not deserve this shit. Okay, it's not for me to decide, but it's my purpose to tell you what I see. I am not a sugarcoating, a reader who just tells you bullshit for the sake of likes. I do not do that. Okay, so if you resonate with this reading, hit the like button. It really helps my channel. If you are not wanting to, it's okay. If you're new to my channel, however, please do subscribe if you like what I do. If you want a personal reading from me, the way I do this reading, like giving you clarity or giving you the truth, please reach out my website and book one for yourself. I'm really sorry if it came off a bit heavy, but that's the way I deliver the reads. Okay, thank you so much for coming in, and I hope to see you soon, guys. Cheers.